Thank you for joining us today. My name is Devin Keenan. I am on the Youth Advisory Committee for 4-H Canada, and I am the representative from Quebec. Joining us today is Nicole McAuley from BASF and Alisa Simon from Kids Help Home Canada.
I'm so glad we're here today to talk about mental health in youth, mental health in the workplace, and importantly, mental health in agriculture. That whole phrase of it's okay to not be okay in terms of normalization and making sure that mental health just becomes part of the overall safety and health conversation, right? Your emotional well-being is just as important and your mental well-being is just as important as your physical well-being. I wonder, Alisa, what's been going on out there?
COVID presented challenges for everybody, regardless of your age. At Kids Help Home, we saw increases of over 100% in our contacts of people coming to us, young people saying, I don't feel right. And sometimes that is potentially a diagnosable condition, like you have anxiety, you have depression, but mental health agencies were closed. And for a lot of young people in rural and remote areas, there might not even be an agency to go to.
I was at home working on the farm. I was isolated. I couldn't see other friends and family except for my parents and siblings. So for myself, in order to cope with that, my mechanism was just to work harder and bury down all that isolation. So I was working 80 hours a week, not seeing any other friends and family. And as you can imagine, that was not a very good combination for my mental health. Males are typically have a harder time being able to talk about their emotions and reach out to people. And also because I am in a remote area, it's hard to have resources. It's hard to find people who are open about willing to help. And also just being from a farm, you know, I talked with Ocal de Famille Agricole, and they said 40% of Canadian producers would feel uneasy seeking professional help due to what other people might think.
Another organization that's doing a lot of work in this space is Do More Ag. They're more national in their scope, and they do have resources like crisis lines, safe spaces, clinicians, people who are trained and able to have conversations with growers across Canada. And specifically, they offer agriculture training to those clinicians. The interesting piece around Do More is that they've connected those dots between the insights and value behind speaking to someone about mental health, whether that's depression or burnout or anxiety. We all know that, you know, agriculture and being a farmer means you are dealing with the complexities and unknowns of the season ahead.
Lisa, I find one of the hardest steps is, like you said, first just being able to talk to someone and say, hey, I'm having this issue. What's one thing you or a couple of things you could recommend to push that first step?
So I think that the first thing is just having the courage to pick up the phone or get on your computer and chat, somehow reach out to a place like Kids Help Phone. The biggest act of courage is that moment of reaching out. And what I always say is every single person, doesn't matter where you live, doesn't matter who you are, every single one of us struggles. Mm-hmm. Some of us struggle more, some of us struggle less, and we struggle different times in our lives. And the important thing is whatever you're going through, no matter how much you feel like you're the only one who's ever felt this bad, there are people there to help you because we've all actually felt that bad. Right. And so it's that normalizing of those yucky feelings that just feel overwhelming and that make you feel weak or make you feel weird or make you feel disconnected. It's okay. And if you reach out, we can help you think through that.
I'd like to thank Nicole McAuley from BASF and Alisa Simon from Kids Help Phone Canada for joining us today. And stay tuned for other episodes.